Hello, trumpet students. This is Brett Lemley with the Brass Studio at brettlemley.com and Learn Trumpet on YouTube. If you're looking for lessons, look in the description down below and visit my website. In this video, we're going to be looking at number 48 in the Essential Elements Band Method. This is High School Cadets, a very famous method, very famous march by John Philip Sousa. So please search for High School Cadets March and look at the Marine Band, the United States Marine Band recording of High School Cadets. I think you'll get a kick out of it. We're also learning about tempo markings. Tempo means time, and tempo markings tell us how fast or slow to go. And we're learning three tempo markings. So let's just read the orange box together for a moment. It says, tempo is the speed of music. Tempo markings are usually written above the staff in Italian. The Italians were the ones that came up with these, so they get naming rights. Makes sense, right? So we're going to learn three tempo markings, and from now on, we're going to be paying careful attention to tempo whenever we practice these tunes. Allegro means a fast tempo. Moderato is only one letter different from a similar English word, moderate. Middle of the road, right? So a moderato is a medium tempo, and then andante means a slower walking tempo. Andante literally means in Italian walking speed. Allegro means lively and spirited, so that's a little bit faster. Okay, so for the High School Cadets, we have a tempo marking of allegro, and we have a dynamic of forte. So not only are we going to be playing faster, we're going to be playing a little bit louder. Okay, so as per usual for a bunch of the recent videos, I'm going to be playing this three times. I'm going to be playing it at 60, and then I'm going to bump it up to 90. I usually stop at 75, but I'm going to bump it up to 90 because a typical marched tempo is 120. So the third time I play it, I'm going to play it at a typical march tempo, which is 120 beats a minute. So the first tempo is going to be 60. The second tempo is going to be 90. So practice 60 a lot. And then practice 90 a lot so you can play along with me at a real march tempo, which is about 120. Okay, here's 60. Make sure you get all the water out of your instrument. There we go. All right, here we go. Oh, and we're also starting on beat. Think about it for a second. What beat are we starting on? Two. Okay, here we go. So one, two, one, and two, and... tricky. The last two or three measures are a little bit tricky, so work those out. Spend a lot of time working on those. When you can play that confidently at 60, work your way up to 90. Here we go. One, two, one, two. Kind of quick, but we're going to go even quicker because a real march goes around here. Okay? Bum, 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 bum. So, if you've practiced this a lot and you're really confident with it, try playing along at this tempo. And if you're super confident, close your eyes. Here we go. One, two, one, two. I made it. Okay, so you may not get all the way to 120. That's okay. You've got plenty of time to get your tempo up. Marches are a lot of fun. I grew up on marches. I love John Philip Sousa marches, and I hope you have a good time with this one. Have fun, happy practicing, and I'll see you next time.